Welcome to the chemistry class. Today we want to discuss about the preparation of the alcohols, that is the methods of preparation of the alcohol. As you know, we are in our last class we have discussed about the classification, nomenclature and structure of the functional group, and today we want to discuss about the preparation of the alcohols. So there are different types of the reactions will be there and different type of the reactants we are going to take in order to prepare the alcohol. In that, first one method is we are going to prepare the alcohol by using the alkene. First method is from alkene. We want to prepare the alcohol, that is general formula is ROH, by using the alkene. Okay, so that particular method is known as acid catalyzed hydration of alkene. Okay, so it is very important. Several times this question is asked for 3 marks because it consisting of the 3 steps in it. So it is the one of the important question which is repeatedly asked in your examination. So let's look at that acid catalyzed hydration of the alkene. So we want to prepare the alcohol by using the alkene. So what will be the general formula of alkene? See, alkene means carbon to carbon double bond. So what we are telling, acid catalyzer, it means we are using here an acid. We are using an acid, that is I wrote as H plus. It means this H plus is available through any one of the acid. So it is acid catalyzer, and hydration I am telling means we want to add here water. Okay, so what we want to prepare? We want to prepare the alcohol. So here OH is attached. Okay, so OH is there means that is the alcohol, and we are adding H2O. It consisting of the H and OH, H plus and OH minus. So one of the H is added here, one of the OH is added here. So we prepare the alcohols. So why we are using acid catalyzer? Because acid is there. Hydration we are using means we want to take the water. Okay, so let's talk about the one of the example. For example, ethene. Ethene, when it undergoes acid catalyzed hydration, so what happens? There is a formation of the one of the hydrogen is added here. So one, when the hydrogen is added, for example, take here, when this hydrogen is added here, this double bond will going to be break and OH will going to be add here. So that only happened in case of the this format. And similarly here, add one of the H here, it becomes CH3, and the double bond is reduced to single. The double bond is reduced to single and it is CH2. What else remained? OH group is remained. Okay, ethanol is formed. From ethene to we have prepared ethanol. Ethene to ethanol we want to prepare. So this is a symmetrical alkene. If I am taking unsymmetrical alkene, during that time how the product is observed? See here, take any one of the unsymmetrical alkene, for example this one. Okay, so when it undergoes hydration, that is acid catalyzed hydration, during that time what will be the product? Just add H here and OH here. What happens? For this carbon I am adding OH. Okay, then this double bond is broken, so that there is a formation of the single bond, and then one of the H is added here. So this is the product, and this product is on the basis of the Markovnikov's rule. Okay, so see here, we want to talk about the methods of preparation of the alcohol. The first method is we want to prepare the alcohol by using the alkene. So what is the name of that particular method? Is acid catalyzed hydration of the alkene. So whenever alkene is treated with an acid in presence of a water, we are going to get the alcohol as a product. So how exactly it happens, I will explain you through the mechanism itself. Okay, and then whenever we have, this is the general format. And now let's talk about, this is a symmetrical alkene. When the symmetrical alkene is treated with a water in presence of the acid, there is a formation of the alcohol. When unsymmetrical, that is unsymmetrical alkene is taken, during that time also alcohol is prepared, and this method is based on the Morkonikov's rule. So now I said you how ethene is going to be converted into ethanol. That only we will talk about in case of by taking the mechanism, how exactly the process occurs. So this mechanism only they are going to ask you, write the mechanism how we are going to convert alkene into alcohol, and this is the question which is asked for the 3 marks. So let's look at that. So this mechanism involves 3 steps. This mechanism involves 3 steps. In that, first one is protonation of alkene. Protonation of the alkene to form carbocation, to form the carbocation by electrophilic attack of H3O plus. Okay. So this is the first step. Exactly what is the meaning of that, I will tell you. First, see here, we are telling acid catalyzed hydration. It means we are using the acid, we are using the water. So let's look at that. This H plus is generated from the acid, and we are using the water. Whenever these two react with each other, there is a formation of the electrophile. It means there is a formation of the H3O plus hydronium ion, we are going to say it, hydronium ion. So as it has the plus charge, means it acts as an electrophile. Then this can have the tendency to attack on the double bond, because double bond is electron rich system. Our alkene consisting of the double bond means it is electron rich center, so that this electrophile can able to attack on it, this electrophile can able to attack on it. So that is also occurs in the first step only. Okay, so here carbon to carbon double bond, there is a alkene, and this only I am going to write in such a way that yes or no, this is nothing but the our hydronium ion only, H3O. Okay, now the carbon, the oxygen has the positive charge. Whether it is stable, it is not stable. It does not want this positive sign. So what happens, this double bond will going to interact with the hydrogen. So that it can drag this electron towards itself. When it can able to drag it, it must be attracted by someone. So it will be attracted by the carbon to carbon double bond. So during that time, what happens, whenever this H gets attached here, while this oxygen takes this bonded electron towards itself. So what will be the structure next? See here, this H is attached to this carbon like this. Okay, and this bond is, that is attached only means it is converted into single bond, and this carbon gets the positive charge. This carbon gets the positive charge because its one of the bond is broken. It means it become, that is electron richness is lost. So it will going to get the plus charge, and this becomes as it is H2O. Okay, so this is the first step. In the first step, protonation, it means addition of the H plus, protonation of alkene. It means we are adding H here, that is protonation of alkene to form what? To form the carbocation. This is the carbocation, to form the carbocation. How it is formed? By the attack of this one, by the attack of the electrophile hydronium ion. So this is the first step. So in case of second step, nucleophilic attack of water on carbocation. Okay, see here, this is our product from the first step, yes or no? This is the product from the, so now this water will going to attack on it. Now this water will going to attack on it. As you know, it is positive, it is negatively charged. During that time, what happens? See here, like this structure is arised. So here O yes or no? So O is attached through it, oxygen got the three bonds, it means it carries the positive charge and two hydrogen will be there. This is the second step, that is nucleophile. It water acts as a nucleophile, nucleophilic attack of water on the carbocation. So this is the second step, and last step is deprotonation deprotonation to form alcohol. Okay, so how the deprotonation means, if I remove this hydrogen, if I remove this hydrogen, what happens? OH group is attached to the carbon. OH group is attached to the carbon. If I remove this hydrogen, it means removing this hydrogen is directly possible? It is not directly possible. So we are removing means proton is removing means that step what we called deprotonation. So how it happens? See here, this is H and here plus H and H and like this. So further water will going to take this hydrogen, water will going to take this hydrogen. So this bond is shifted here, this bond is shifted here. So what will be our product? Carbon to carbon here. As if it is removed means what else attached to the carbon? OH group is attached to the carbon. For this carbon already hydrogen is there as it is, and what else remained for this carbon? OH is attached to the this carbon, and so finally there is a removal of the H3O plus. As it acts as a catalyst, the catalyst is regenerated in the last step, and there is a formation of the alcohol. Yes or no? See here, once again I will tell you, first of all we want to prepare the alcohol by using the alkene. By which method we are preparing the alcohol? That is by using the alkene. The name of the method is acid catalyzed hydration of the alkene. So for the alkene we are adding the acid along with the water. For the alkene, we are adding the acid along with the water. That's why this is known as acid catalyzed hydration of the alkene. So just look at the alkene. Alkene consisting of the carbon to carbon double bond. Okay, so I am adding water, as I said you hydration, as I said you acid catalyzer means H plus must be present. So there is a formation of the alcohol, that is OH is attached to it. ROH is the general format of the alcohol. If OH is present means that is a class of the alcohol. So we attached the OH here means we prepared the alcohol. Clear? So there are two possibilities. One is by taking the symmetrical alkene. One more is by taking the unsymmetrical alkene. If I took the symmetrical alkene, that is ethene, when it undergoes acid catalyzed hydration, so what happens? There is a formation of the ethanol. Simple step, just break this double bond, add hydrogen to one carbon, add OH to the another carbon, or attach. See here, I have added one hydrogen here so that it becomes CH3. and double bond I broken, I converted that into single bond and I have attached the OH group. Then how I am attaching that? Water itself indicates H plus and OH minus. So OH is attached here and H is attached here. So there is no problem when the given alkene is symmetrical. Suppose if it is unsymmetrical, it means we cannot able to cut this break, it cannot able to fold on each other. So it is unsymmetrical alkene. During that time, according to the Morkonikov's rule, the product is preferred. So this product is possible and you have studied this reaction in your first POC. So that's why it is not given much explanation in your second POC. Just keep in mind that for unsymmetrical alkene, if we are carried out acid catalyzed hydration, it occurs through the Morkonikov's rule and the product will be this one. For the carbon where it is having the less number of the hydrogen, there OH must be attached. Okay. So next we will talk about the mechanism of the acid catalyzed hydration of the alkene, and here we are preferring the alkene which is symmetrical, which is symmetrical. So it involves the three steps. First step, protonation of the alkene to form the carbocation by the electrophilic attack of the H3O plus, that is hydronium ion. So first take the alkene. Instead of taking alkene, first we want to prepare the, what we are making attacking? Electrophile attack must be there to prepare what? Carbocation. So first there must be electrophile generation. How it is generated? From the acid we have H plus, water is there, there is a formation of the hydronium ion. And next, this hydronium ion will going to interact with the alkene. So as oxygen is electropositive, it wants to drag the electron from it, but this hydrogen must be removed. So this hydrogen, the double bond will going to be attract here. So this hydrogen gets attached to the this carbon, and the carbon which is lost its bond, that got the positive charge. So what else? This H2O is separated. This is the first. In the next, nucleophilic attack of water, this only acts as a nucleophile and it will going to attack on this one, it will going to attack on this one, that only nucleophilic attack of water on the carbocation. Here we generated the carbocation, for this only water will going to interact. So here it will going to attack on this one. So what happens? There is a formation of the intermediate like this. There is a formation of the intermediate. See here, CH and this bonding will be there. For this carbon, H2O is attached. It is nothing but H2O. But oxygen got the three bonds, so the positive charge. Again, oxygen is not ready to take the positive charge, and we want to prepare the alcohol, means I have to remove one of the hydrogen, either here or here. So COH is attached. So in order to remove this H, that is proton we want to remove, means deprotonation. We want to remove means deprotonation. So the last step is deprotonation to form the alcohol. So in order to remove one of TH, what we want to prefer? Again we want to prefer the water. So whenever water acts on it, this bond got shifted here. This H is taken by this water. So there is a formation of the alcohol. For the carbon, OH is attached, here H is attached, and finally the H3O plus hydronium ion, as it is regenerated. I hope so this is clear for you, and this is one of the important bit of the topic, and each step carries one marks, so that this question is asked for the 3 marks. Sometimes they will ask you not only the general mechanism, they will ask you that write the mechanism for acid catalyzed hydration of the ethene to ethanol. If I took this one as CH to CH2, okay, so what will be prepared? Here only I have shown ethene, water, that is acid catalyzed hydration, ethanol is formed, and here in this mechanism I have explained generally. So the homework is that you have to write the mechanism by taking first example. take the ethene as the reactant here and follow up the steps, and all you have to write the three steps by taking the ethene as an example. Okay, further methods of preparation we will continue in our next class. Thank you.